stop you crying, it will be alright. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will protect you from all around you. I will be here, don't you cry. For one so small, you seem so strong. My arms will hold you, keep you safe. They can't explain. I know we're different, but deep inside us, we're not that different at all. And you'll be in my heart. Yes, you'll be in my heart.
Dr. Michael A. Johnson was a loyal, lifelong resident of the Winford community. As a member of the first graduating class of Winford High School, he was honored to serve as president of the class of 1964. After graduation, Mike pursued a career in medicine, receiving his undergraduate degree from the Ohio State University. After graduating from medical school in Guadalajara, Mexico, he worked as a medical intern in Muncie, Indiana. Mike was fluent in Spanish, and while in Muncie, he enjoyed serving in migrant clinics. Mike decided to move back home, and in April of 1976, he opened his family practice medical office in Bucyrus.
While Dr. Johnson was very busy with his growing family and building his family practice, he always found time to give back to the community in many ways. He was especially fond of his alma mater, Winford, and volunteered his time caring for the student athletes as team doctor. His door was always open after games and Saturday mornings to care for injured student athletes, assure their parents, and set them on the best course for recovery. For more than 30 years, Dr. Johnson was an essential part of recruiting, arranging, and performing school physicals for student athletes. While this service began with the Winford students, over the years it expanded to include other local school district student athletes. The coordination by Dr. Johnson with other local physicians and nurses provided an immeasurable benefit for generations of student athletes from Winford and surrounding school districts. This service made this required element of high school sports convenient, accessible, and economical for all the student athletes' families.
Dr. Johnson particularly enjoyed volunteering time running the scoreboard for the boys' varsity and JV basketball games, a permanent fixture at the scorer's table for over 25 years, allowed him to be courtside and watch his three sons and four of his grandsons play for the Royals. For the many years of service to Winford Athletics as team doctor, he was honored to be inducted into Winford's Athletic Hall of Fame as part of the 2007-2008 class, and was recently posthumously inducted into the Crawford County Sports Hall of Fame. Mike also served many roles in the community, including Health First Medical Director, Crawford County Coroner, Crawford County Health Commissioner, and Little League Board Member.
Mike and I were more than brothers. We were best friends. We would talk almost every day. We analyzed every Winford and Ohio State football and basketball games. We should have been coaches. I'm sure we'd have never lost a game. I almost got Mike tossed out of a basketball game. I was trying to help an official that just made several wrong calls. He thought it was Mike, stopped and called him out. Mike said, "That wasn't me. I didn't do that, and I never would." About all I ever did to help Winford sports was help officials. Mike, on the other hand, would do all the physicals for all sports, not only for Winford, but for the whole county. He would recruit doctors, and they would do all the physicals, and then Mike and Sally would have him over for a cookout that night. Mike was there for every student athlete that got injured, whether it was on the field or on the court, not only for Winford, but for visiting teams also. When the boy from Shelby broke his wrist, Mike was getting up almost as he hit the floor. I was with Mike at Buckeye Central when an official had a heart attack. He helped save his life by getting him aspirin from someone in the crowd and staying with him until they got him to the hospital. Coaches from all the schools in the county would call Mike day and night for advice on injured athletes. He would go to the office sometimes after our game late at night to see students that got hurt at other schools. Mike and Chuck at the scorer's table all those years, what a team. I could go on and on, but this is a great honor for Mike, a well-deserved honor. If God allows us to see anything, I'm sure Mike is with us tonight.
How fitting it is that this gymnasium is going to be named after Dr. Michael A. Johnson. Dr. Mike, as a lot of people called him, or Doc Johnson, is very deserving of this honor. I'm very fortunate to have Mike as a very close friend, and probably more than anything, I was able to sit with Mike at the scorer's table for 20 plus years. Sitting there with Mike just really showed me how much of a caring person he was, and how much time that he would spend with the athletes, and not only just the athletes, but people that would come up and talk to Mike and ask him about different things, and he was always there to help them and talk to them. So once again, I think this is very fitting and very deserving. Mike is a great role model for our community, for our students, and for everybody that passes through the doors of this gymnasium. Congratulations, Mike, and the entire Johnson family.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Dr. Michael Johnson Gymnasium. Has a nice ring to it, doesn't it? I'd like to tell you a little bit about Dr. Johnson and my friendship with him over the past 30, 35 years. I've had a lot of conversations with him, and I've always felt at ease and have watched him around a lot of different situations and around a lot of people, and been to his office quite a few times over the years and had great conversations there. He was a special person that brought out the best in people with his friendliness and his ability to help people who needed things. And I'm sure there's thousands of stories out there that I will never be aware of, that a lot of you guys are aware of. He made me feel very welcome at Winford in my early days. And we had a lot of great conversations, especially in the back hallway during basketball games, between games and at halftimes. We would go back there and talk, and I think that one of his jobs was to go back and schmooze a little bit on the officials because our coaches had made him angry. It was one of his jobs. And I don't know if you guys know this or not, it's kind of a secret, that he did a lot of coaching with especially Coach Sheldon. I don't know if you guys know this, but Coach Sheldon didn't know anything about defense and basketball in his early years. And Dr. Johnson talked him into learning about defense and implementing defense at Winford, which made his career very successful. Thank you, Dr. Johnson. Anyhow, a little bit more about Dr. Johnson, and I think there's no better person that I know of that led by example on how we should talk, how we should act, how we should be generous, how we should be patient and show gratitude. He did a marvelous job of just being a great person and showing us how to be a good person. And things that I'll try to remember him by is acting and being a better person because of some of the examples that he led us. Sally and kids, thank you for sharing your husband and your dad. He gave me a lot of laughs, a lot of witty conversations, a lot of laughing. I am very proud to have been his friend. I remember our last conversation. I was over in his shop maybe 6 or 8 months before he passed, and He gave me a tour of the shop that we had talked about for, I don't know, at least 5 or 6 years, and showed me some of his projects. And we even went to Stephen Shelley's house and looked at some of the projects over there, and I had a great time and will remember him. He is very deserving to have his name on this new gymnasium. And I want to thank you for your attention tonight, and go Royals.
Greg and I appreciate the opportunity to express our excitement in the naming of the new Winford Gymnasium.
Dr. Mike has so many accomplishments that make him more than qualified to receive this honor. He was a member of the first Winford graduating class. He was a team doctor and ran the scoreboard for over 30 years, just to name a few.
As a team doctor, Dr. Johnson took care of anyone and every medical situation. If a player went down, there was always a concern, but to see Dr. Johnson come immediately out of the stands was very calming. He was always there, and he was always gave them the care that they needed.
If we had an appointment with Dr. Johnson for a cold or had to take my mother Lois because of an illness, we always wanted to get the exam over because Dr. Johnson liked to chat with us about Winford basketball. Over the years, the best medicine for my mother was talking with Dr. Johnson. And of course, basketball always made her feel better.
Ironically, we heard if Dr. Mike had gone into the hospital for treatment at a Winford basketball game. Dr. Johnson always took such good care of everyone. What could everyone else do to help him? It was then that the Winford community and everyone else who knew him began covering him in deep prayer. He went into treatment because of the love that he had for his family and friends and to help others. John 15:13 says it's best. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend.
Mike was an outstanding doctor, a good friend, and a loyal Royal. We miss him terribly, but in naming of the gymnasium, Dr. Michael Johnson, MD, in his memory, he will live on forever. We are sure he is watching over all of us, and especially his family, as they continue the basketball tradition at Winford. Thank you.
I feel humbled and extremely honored to have been asked to say a few words about such a great man on such a special night. But to use just a few words to describe Mike Johnson almost seems impossible, even though a few do jump right out. Honesty, caring, family. And Mike and Sally hold a special place in my heart because they treated me like their seventh kid. And to this day, Matt, Shelly, Chris, Mindy, Josh, and Emily feel like brothers and sisters. But one story I shared with Mike does stand out. It was after a tough loss in the Final Four my senior year, in which during the game my left ear got ripped open. Right after the game, Mike went right to work, snipping away cartilage and stitching me up right there in the locker room as my teammates' tears turned to laughter at my demise. So every time I walked into his office for years after that, he'd grab my left ear and he'd look at it close and he'd say, "Grover, that's some of my best work. I think I should have been a plastic surgeon." Well, I think I speak for the whole community when we all know he'd have been a great plastic surgeon, but thank God he served us as our doctor because he got to touch so many more lives that way. So thank you for honoring one of the Winford family tonight. And above all else, go Royals!
Such an honor to be involved in this dedication ceremony. We all know Mike was a pillar of the community, and we must be thankful and not forget how lucky we are to have had this man so active in our Winford athletic system. I've been to a lot of ball games with Mike, and I know the many countless and unselfish hours that he put in before, during, and after the games. It was just amazing. And in ending, I'd like to say I was quite pleased, as well as my family and the friends I talked to, that the Board of Education chose to name this place Dr. Michael A. Johnson Gymnasium. I think I've been hard-pressed to find a better name.
It has been my honor and pleasure to call Mike Johnson a friend. He was behind every game I ever coached. Last one in the locker room after a win, the first one in the locker room after one of our losses. I am so thankful that I have had an opportunity to spend the quality time that Mike and I had together. Nobody is more deserving than the recognition that Mike's about to get. First graduating class of Winford, there is no person that is more a Winford Royal than Mike Johnson. I will love him forever.
It is a privilege and a great honor to have the opportunity to pay tribute to my doctor and my friend, Mike Johnson. When I think of Mike Johnson, two things come to mind: servant leadership and inspiration. For decades, he humbly served as Winford's team athletic doctor, serving thousands of athletes over the course of several decades, in addition to serving the residents of Crawford County with his medical practice. The class, the courage, and the optimism which Mike displayed during the last months of his life is certainly a legacy we should all aspire to emulate. And I am so glad that we have decided to honor his legacy by naming this gymnasium after Mike Johnson.
Having this gymnasium named after Dr. Mike Johnson is truly a great honor, but it actually means so much more than that. For the great people in the Winford School District that have made this facility happen, it represents everything that Mike represented himself. And that was a person that believed in giving so much more than taking, a person that believed in serving much more than being served. And for generations to come that come into this gymnasium, they're going to see that name and ask who Dr. Mike Johnson was. And that's exactly what is going to be expressed about Dr. Mike. And as a result of that, this is truly a great honor. And on behalf of the family and so many others, thank you.
Hi, I'm Rhonda Rowland, and I just thank God for the opportunity to know Dr. Michael A. Johnson. Mike Johnson brought a calming presence to every person that was blessed to encounter him. Mike always brought a sense of warmth and peace that is impossible to replicate as it is to forget. Mike Johnson brought that incredible presence with him everywhere he went, from his doctor's office to the community to this gym. To look at the scores table and to see Mike Johnson sitting there gave you that warmth, that feeling of trust, and that understanding that this really was a very special place for our community to gather. It was such a pleasure to take nominations for the naming of this gymnasium. And it was also such a pleasure to hear Dr. Michael Johnson's name over and over again. I would always ask why. And the stories that I heard were so heartwarming, unbelievable stories about how he helped others, how he didn't want recognition, his integrity, his steadiness, his kindness, his love for others that made naming this gym after Michael A. Johnson the right choice.
For me, Dr. Michael A. Johnson was a constant reminder of God's goodness. He was gifted, and he took those gifts to help others, earning trust and guiding so many people through happy times and those difficult times. We were very blessed to call him friend, and today we are blessed to carry on his legacy. Dr. Michael A. Johnson, a friend to all.